ever find, the more wretched hive of scum and villainy. We must be cautious.
Here's Kojak, hanging out. He's got his bully stick, which basically makes it easy for me to like live because he nips at my feet all the time. Anyway, I wanted to say hi to the Phantom Menace and my subscribers and viewers and everybody out there. He's got a lot to say, and he told me to say it. And to begin with, this is Daniel Jose Older, writer of Last Shot, trolling Gina Carano for asking out loud why masks during Corona are still being used when they don't work. And basically, she asked that the lockdown be stopped because it's destroying people's lives. And of course, Mr. Left-Wing Latinx had to freak out. So here it is. Hey guys, Steph, welcome back to the Cantina. Remember, tip the Wookiee bartenders 20%. No droids, no bounty hunters, no Raylos, no Ray Nobodies, no Disney canon fans of any kind. I've got two things to talk about. First off, Daisy Ridley admits that there was no plan for the Disney trilogy. In fact, she said at first JJ was toying with the idea of making her Rey Kenobi, which again defeats the purpose of Skywalker saga. Second of all, then, you know, Rey Nobody, Rey Palpatine, of course, was the final result. But there were other iterations in between, probably Rey Solo, Rey Skywalker, something that would actually make sense. All right, I have a complaint. If you're looking for Captain Crunch film, McDonald's film, film by Taco Bell, no substance at all, go to J.J. Abrams, he's your man. Just this whole story that Daisy told, and she told, everybody's been talking about it, says to me that J.J. Abrams wasn't the guy to direct episode 7 or 9, that he's not really a fan of Star Wars. He could say he is, but he's not really a fan. You know, his claim to fame was he basically you know, had a patron named Steven Spielberg, you know, and we all know that Steven Spielberg is your patron. You're basically going to have cachet everywhere you go, even if you are like him, like JJ, an untalented hack. Okay. So I'm not down with the Rey Kenobi thing. And the reason simply is this: it goes against who Kenobi was as a character, as George saw him. It goes against what Kenobi tried to accomplish with Anakin, which is be a decent Jedi. Obi-Wan was the classic Jedi. He was the classic Jedi. You know, to do this to the character, to make him basically, in my opinion, a deadbeat dad, J.J. Happily was going to do the same thing to Obi-Wan that he did to Han Solo. But again, J.J.'s a lefty, white man bad, okay? Let's go to the next one. We talked about Boyega. Boyega basically saying that Disney Star Wars basically tokenized Finn, lied about who Finn was going to be, marginalized him for the Chinese audience, which is what they did, which is racism. They also, Rose Tico, to me, when I think about it, was nothing more than a tool to take up Finn's time so Ryan could explore the vestiges of fucking Raylo. Okay, so these two actors that were in Star Wars are now calling them out. No plan. But then again, you have to ask both JJ and Ryan, are you really Star Wars fans? Because there's not a modicum of understanding for any of this, right? None. Okay, let's go to this next one. This is really kind of funny. Gina Carano getting trolled by Daniel Jose Older, the novelist, activist, who wrote Last Shot, which was basically an attack on Han Solo. Basically, he just happily destroyed the character even more. You know, backed up the dumpster truck over him and then dumped a load of dog shit on him. You know, in this book, we have Han being, you know, racist against Gungans and being mean to Ben and getting punched out by Lando. Because white man bad and they hate Han Solo. But then, of course, you know, if you put Harrison Ford at about the age of 35 and older in the same room and a bunch of single women, who are they going to look at? They're going to look at Harrison Ford. All right. This to me, when I see Harrison Ford, this character, Han Solo, who was the big heartthrob in the original trilogy, being slammed like this by both men and women who are of the left wing, beta male, feminazi. It's the idea that, hey, these beta males can't compete. All right. And these women are afraid of heterosexual sex and don't know what to do about it. And therefore they have to marginalize a guy that exudes that masculinity to make themselves feel better and feel empowered. Thing about sexuality and that closeness between a man and a woman, both sides are vulnerable and it's okay. If you're in love with them, it's okay. Okay, these women are afraid to be vulnerable. They're afraid of men. They're afraid of alpha males. They're afraid of men like that because the outcome of a relationship with that could be sex. And of course, older looks at this and thinks, wow, you know, I'd have to compete with that and I can't. No shit, Sherlock. That there's a reason why you're a writer monkey and he's a movie star. Okay, so what am I saying? I'm just saying that this is all very interesting. This is all coming out. And of course, we have a member of the writers group basically bitching at one of the stars of The Mandalorian, the only thing successful that Disney Star Wars has accomplished in the last few years. Think about that. This is Steph signing out. Oh, and the tweet is what Older sent to Gina. Let's see around the galaxy. And again, here's Older's attack on Gina.